September 2018, my most favorite month of the year, because this is a year where I usually, normally, take a full assessment of which road have I traveled up till now and what is the future road that I want to take. Am I comfortable in the position that I have kept myself in, or do I need to make this changes in life? With all the eclipses that have happened before September have shaken all of us up and have made us realize a certain hard facts, and that how it is important to change our attitude, which actually determines our altitude. So September onwards, when the planets actually start going direct and making the grand trines, we can actually make ourselves more successful, and successful in the terms of achieving the mental and the physical peaks that we so desire. Remember that Saturn is going direct on September 6th. Saturn always demands determination, discipline, and dedication, not only to yourself, but also to the work that you are doing. So it's very important to keep it in mind as you are listening to the predictions of your particular zodiac. You have to side by side keep introspecting where is it that you are going wrong and how you can correct it. My simple advice here is that now when Saturn is going direct, all the corrections that you have done in your life, you are bound to receive the rewards of it. In case if you have not done the corrections, then September is a fruitful month where all the incorrect can be corrected. So three simple words can change your life: determination towards your goal, dedication towards your goal by the way of not hard work, but enjoying the work that you are wanting or you are doing. In case if you are not enjoying the work you are doing, then find a work which you will truly enjoy. And till the time you find that work, to actually dedicate yourself that is actually holding the purses for you, that is giving you your bread and butter. Overall, last but not the least, discipline. Use your freedom constructively, use your freedom with discipline, and you're bound to enjoy it for long. September 28 Pisces for you. Well, late last month, the planets made an important shift from the lower half of your horoscope to the upper half. The balance of power towards the top half is even stronger this month. So, where in past months you were striving to feel good and to build a stable home base, now you'll be focusing on the outer world and your career objectives. You can safely de-emphasize home and family issues and focus on your career now. The main career challenge, like last month, is balancing it with very active and happy social life. The temptation to lose yourself in the social world will be great, but ignoring your career would be a mistake. Give it its due. The planets are still very much in the west. Your seventh house of love is ultra powerful. Though you have much self-confidence and know what is right for you and what is not right for you, you have to sublimate much of your self-will to placate other people. So like last month, this is a challenge. You've got to mind your temper and beware of irritation and impatience. Even your voice tones, though you say nothing that is out of order, will be picked up by the others and could cause complications that you don't need it. Cultivate the social graces now. Fill your mind with love and loving thoughts, and feelings of anger will automatically dissipate. Speak softly, give in on issues that don't affect your principles or major purposes in life. Don't argue for argue's sake, or don't even say things just to prove your intelligence. Silence speaks more than your words. Finances are still not what they should be, and this is because a lot of internal and subjective development has to happen in your financial life. Seeds need to germinate in the ground before they can sprout, and if you have not sown the seeds, then now is the time to sow those seeds. This is the situation you are in. After the 23rd, you start seeing some improvement, and more improvements after the 27th, when your financial planet actually moves more consistently. Continue to study all major purchases and investments more thoroughly until the 27th. In fact, if you can delay important financial decisions until then, all the better. Of course, the Mars shifting its gears shouldn't stop you from shopping, but only shop what you need, not what you desire. Keep away the big items for a later date. Love remains amazingly good. All the important beneficial planets are still camped out in your 7th house until the 15th. Great and loving geniuses are meticulously mapping out social happiness for you. It's difficult to see how you could avoid it. Love makes the world go round this month. Even the retrograde of your love planet until the 20th will not stop you from happening. This one factor will simply be outgunned by the good. Health needs more attention until the 23rd. Try to rest and relax more where possible. Enhance your health by paying more attention to your intestine, kidneys, and hips. Overall, it is a month where you declutter your mind, declutter your heart, and just realize, because what you speak is what will matter. And of course, for your best days, your stressful days, the days for your love and romance, and the days for your finances, you'll have to visit my website. In fact, if you individualistically want to know what is it that is going to bring to you, then of course natal charts are very, very important. And the way I have seen the trend in the past couple of years, I would say every individual who exactly knows how he is capable of actually charging and walking towards his achievements in life or whatever goals he set for himself. For that, knowing your potentials, knowing your talents, and knowing your destiny through the natal chart is extremely important.